definition of life without a purpose, without a cause, meaningless and faith.
Riches and fame, striving in lust, to the pleasure of death, beauty is vain. Status and power, lust and time, pursuit of flesh, all begun. The deeper you dive in, you lose yourself. Destruction and darkness, condemnation and
Hello Chief, we are here.
Don't be lost, come back home, he's waiting.
Riches and fame, striving in lust, to the pleasure of day, beauty is vain.
Sabila, you have my room to where Chief paid for.
Chief is in his house entertaining one of his guests. So,
this way is free for
we
us.
Have the pleasure.
Jump!
Leave him alone!
Jump!
Leave him alone!
Leave him alone! Leave him alone!
Isabella, are you not going to this party?
Well, I wasn't invited, so no.
Hey, see this babe, though. Shoo. Babe, But she be invited before you go. I beg again, just stand up from that bed, let's be going. Like, stand up fast, fast, like now.
I'm going back to sleep.
Go. Get up.
Stand up.
Raga, I'm going to
Stand up.
He's going to say to you guys, like, I'm really scared. I can't go with you.
Just go.
Okay, let's go.
Very sorry, Wilikma.
Oh, okay. So, oh, Mike, you came just in time. We're just about to talk about your political ambition. This is Mike. Introduce yourself to him, actually.
Sir, my name is Michael, and I'm from the students.
What makes you feel the fellowship should support you for your political ambition?
What do you mean, sir?
Oh, you think you are fit for the political terrain?
I think believers should have their say in politics, sir.
No, I don't think so. Matured believers should take their place in politics.
And I'm not a mature believer?
You don't understand. Do you know that politics is not for just anybody?
Sir, I'm not saying it's going to be easy, but I'm ready to give it whatever it takes.
Listen, young man, there are three things that bring men down. Power, money, sex.
And I pray I don't fall to any one of them, sir.
Yes, I pray. But just don't pray alone. Watch, because if you don't, the enemy will mess you up.
I believe you, sir.
And who are you?
My name is...
To speak. This is Monarch, actually. He's one of our political aspirants as well, from the fellowship.
I don't care. You don't have political people here. This is political Judas.
How do you mean?
My name is Judas, sir, not Judas.
I don't care. Pastor Faith, if you need me...
The confessors.
I will be here.
And I know you will need me. Have a peaceful night rest.
What's the investors? What's going on here?
This student union has spent a lot of time deliberating the school activities in order that we are going to do. We spent way too much time, so we need to make a decision. All in all, the beauty pageant has been a repetitive theme. What do you think, sir?
Okay, so we've heard from my advice, and if you're in support of the beauty pageant, please let me see your hands up. Okay, please count.
Six, sir.
Alright, thank you. If you're against this, let me see your hands up. Okay. Nobody? Okay. The beauty pageant stairs.
Please, Piero, make sure you make all the necessary consultations so we have everything solid in the next meeting.
Alright, thank you. So we'll see you in the next meeting. Thank you.
Excuse me.
Yeah, sorry. What do you want?
Four, please.
Wow.
Sorry, what did
you say? Phone. Yes. We have an extra phone. Right here. Right there.
Thank you.
You're welcome. It's Bella Amor?
Yes.
All right. I'm sorry. Has anyone ever told you you're beautiful?
Yes.
Well, you know they're lying, right?
What?
You're not beautiful, Isabella. You're more than beautiful. You're enchanting, magnificent. If there's anything more than beautiful, that's what you are.
You're funny. Thank you.
It's my pleasure.
How are you doing?
I'm
really enjoying the two of you. So Collins, how far? I hope the preparation for the beauty pageant is well in place now.
Well, Chief, that one day, but since this private one is now going to
Collins, don't worry, huh? I will do more. You guys will enjoy me, huh? Collins, I hope Mona can understand the game seriously.
Yeah, I don't run around.
How the parole rules, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So what I will do is that I will make sure one of my boys send an alert to you in the next 20 minutes.
Ah, sure.
I will pay you.
Mona, Baba. I think I would like you to.
Chief.
This guy is a good guy.
He will teach
you.
Chief, that's
right. Take care.
Yes, boss. Had to let them know this because it was very terrible.
What exactly happened?
Can you imagine? Two girls came up to me, they removed their clothes, showed me their pants and bra, asking me if that could go for the beauty pageant.
So you mean you didn't touch them when you saw them in pants and bras, brother Mike?
Silence, please.
So what are you proposing?
I recommend that this competition should not be to celebrate nudity and vulgarity, but instead to portray the beauty and the glory of femininity.
Somebody say hallelujah!
For God's sake, Collins, this is a very serious matter.
No, it's not! Stop making me sound serious. For goodness sake, Michael, if you want girls in scarves and long gowns, you can't find them at the Mona Street. This is not a church program now.
I understand that the president is not on seat. But Mr. Vice President, sir, you need to get my point. What I'm saying is, we shouldn't do things this way simply because this is the way they've been done. No. What happened to us celebrating our African culture and portraying the African woman's feminine virtues instead of just putting her out there as a bad thing,
sir,
or a cheap whore?
You're being derogatory here and it doesn't even make sense.
And it won't be derogatory when they're wearing pants and bra.
Okay,
he has a point.
Let's be calm. It seems this is a very hot topic that we will not finish today, especially with the president not on seat. So we will leave this till next meeting. And in the absence of that, we will reconvene next Thursday.
This is 21st century. don't understand. Why can't they see that this beauty pageant thing is not progressive for the students?
Oh. What did you expect? They don't share your faith. They're not Christians.
Some of them go to church.
Church? I didn't say church. Not everyone that goes to church knows God. Or have the kind of integrity that we're talking about now.
Couple of weeks into this office and I'm already facing a staunch battle of morality. The other day, two females almost stripped themselves naked in front of me.
That must be traumatic for you.
You can see that again.
Young man, you kept on that.
Nah, I don't think I'm right for that yet.
Oh, you can at least join us for dinner.
Dinner? Nah, three is a crowd. And you too can have a good time. You deserve it.
How was it this song?
You know, the usual. Dad? Mom?
Happy anniversary. Oh,
that's romantic.
Come. Thank you, son.
Thank you, Mike.
Oh, you remember?
Did.
Smells nice. Thank you.
Very fine. You know, Mike, I married the most beautiful, amazing woman in the whole wide world.
Jidakova, you made me this beautiful. You picked me up, brushed me up, and molded me into this beautiful queen that I am today. All thanks to you.
You know, my dear, it's utterly impossible for me to bring out what is not there. What I used to do was to bring out what is there.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dad, for loving Mom the way you do.
Well, what do I say?
You know, someday I hope I can love someone the way you love Mom.
Love continually, my dear. So that when she comes, she's going to meet already loving man on ground.
You know, love turns you into an amazing lover when you meet the right person.
Way. All right then.
sweet, sweet, sweet.
Thanks,
good night.
Man.
Good night, Sam.
Does not support ladies exposing their bodies, but to cover them and adorn them for their husbands. But this beauty pageant, or whatever they call it, has debased our ladies into cheap prostitutes on display, and we must vigorously avoid it. Inshallah.
Students are sent to school to make their lives better and not to end their lives through rape. If beauty pageants are going to defeat the purpose in which schools are established, then it is a terrible idea. Since it promotes despicable vices and immorality on campus, I feel like it should be stopped.
I want to see my daughter in her school.
Okay, at the campus. Amazing. I'm just heading that direction too. Please come in. Let me take you there. I should use that opportunity to see her too, you know.
Alright ladies, let me see what you get. 1, 2, ready, go. Beautiful. Okay. All right. Come on, come on, come on. No. I don't want that. You need to catch up. Pick up, okay? And get it one more time. Get it right now. 1, 2, ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 1, 2, 3. I told you to correct yourself one more time. Come on. Don't turn it all the way. All right? Let's do one more time now. 1, 2, ready, go. 5 and 6. Yes, now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this.
Thank you.
Okay, formation, formation. Let's pose.
Is into all this. So you send your daughter to school and this is what she end up doing. I don't understand. Mrs. Umo, you are my friend and Isabella is your daughter, and I mean your only daughter. Now you are going to stop her from all this nonsense. Let her face her studies. Stop her. I let her focus.
Isabella.
That's my advice, so please, please.
Your school today.
You were?
And I was told you went off for a beauty contest rehearsals.
Oh, that. I was going to tell you about that eventually.
That's okay. I'd known ahead of time that a time like this will come for a daughter and mother talk.
Really?
I took a good look at you at the mirror while you were standing there. And reality dawned on me that my daughter has grown into a beautiful young lady. And that very soon, a few years to come, you're going to get married. I remember when I was your age, I was so full of life and optimism. One thing I lacked though, and that changed my destiny or the course of my life, was good counsel. So I promised myself I am going to do that for you.
Counseling? Well, haven't you been doing that all my life?
Well, maybe, but that will be in bits and pieces. But with what happened today, I know I have to do just that right away. Otherwise, I'm going to be in trouble.
What is it, Mom?
Isabella, you are God's promise to me. I had you when all hope was lost that I was ever going to have a child. And then you came. I told you a lie for so long. I lied to you about your father having abandoned us and running away with another woman, leaving just you and I.
Oh.
Isabella, please, I would like you to listen to me and please don't interrupt me until I ask you to.
Mom, you already lied to me before. What guarantee do I have that you're not going to replace it with another one?
Isabella, please, why not listen to me first and then you can judge by yourself if it's the truth or not.
But Mom, how do you expect me to trust you? How do you expect me to believe you? You already lied to me once.
I understand, but Isabella, please don't make this too difficult for me. I came from a family who were three of us as children. And everything was going on well until that fateful day that our parents died in a village clash. So we were all given to different families, you know, that were worse. The father sexually abused me repeatedly. And thereafter, it was the same thing with every other man that came around and laid their hands on me. After a while, I met this French man who said he loved me, and I felt now the story was going to be different. But then he also began to maltreat me, and so I ran away. It was then I realized I was pregnant with him. I did not want to terminate your pregnancy. But I was at the same time distrust. It was at that point that I came across the gospel. Someone preached to me about the love of God and how much God so loved me. Isabella, I needed that love desperately. It's okay, Isabella. God has helped me this far. I'm just concerned about you. I don't want you to walk the way or live the way I've lived my life.
I won't, Mom. I promise, I won't.
But with this beauty contest, Isabella, you're already working along that path.
Mom!
Isabella, please. I don't want you to join that contest.
Come on, Mom. Don't be so pessimistic. And you know what? I'm going to win that beauty contest. And I'm going to dedicate the award just to you. You're such a brave woman. I'd love to be like you when I grow up.
Isabella.
Mom, should I do the catwalk thing for you? Okay. So today I learned that when you're catwalking, you have to stand up really straight, especially because we're going to be on heels the whole time. And then, like, your hands have to be on your shoulder and you have to face your audience directly. And then there's like this whole thing where you turn and there's really
stress.
Come on, Mom. It's going to be fine. I'm going to be fine. Look, stop crying.
Nobody in this council is contributing to what I say.
Guys, this is the chief I told you about, the person sponsoring the whole beauty pageant
program. Oh, thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you so much.
Please,
we really appreciate it, sir.
Pleased to meet you.
These are the ex-schools.
I love the lady. How are you?
Thank you.
Nice to meet you. How are you, love?
Fine, sir.
Looking good.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
I'm Chief. These are the beauty contestants.
Oh, that's good. I think these year pageants are very beautiful. How are you? How are you? What's the name?
Isabella,
that's a lovely name.
Thank you, sir.
Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you too, sir.
Wow. I think we should meet sometime so that I'll take you guys out. What do you think?
No problem, sir.
Wow. Isabella, pleased to meet you once more.
Nice to meet you too, sir.
Yes, I'll see more of you. Take care of them. You know, nobody is like, you need to be taken care of. Don't you think so?
Yes, I do, sir.
Okay. Isabella, pleased to meet you once more.
Nice to meet you too.
Nice seeing you. Alright, thank you. Wow.
And Chief, this is Mona, the person I
told you. Okay, this is the guy you told me about.
Yeah.
Okay. Mona, how are you?
Fine, sir.
So let him meet me.
Okay,
you know?
Yeah.
You know how we roll.
Alright,
thank you.
Do you need a lift?
Do I know you?
Do you need to know me for me to help you? I mean, call me Isabella if you're going.
You know my name.
Wow, so you really don't remember me.
I'm sorry, I really don't remember your name.
It's okay, it's fine.
Okay. You're the registration guy.
Yeah, that's me. The name's Michael.
Nice to meet you. I'm so sorry I forgot your name.
No, it's fine. So where are you heading?
I'm actually heading towards North Campus.
North Campus it is. Coming.
Isabella, why are you scattering that place?
Okay, so I can't find my ID card.
Calm down now. Have you checked the bag news last for your result?
Yes, I've checked. It's not there.
Stop scattering that place because you're not going to arrange it. Isabella.
You guys are not listening to me. I can't find my ID card.
I'm listening to you.
Calm down now. Retrace your steps. What was the last place you saw it? This. Sorry, can you please call back later? I'm really busy, like right now. You guys, just got my ID card. Sorry, please, can you meet me in Mary Hall Potter's Lodge? I'll meet you downstairs now. Thank you so much. You guys would just want my ID card. Where's my costume change?
Before you go, arrange that, please.
For that compliment, but you know, I'm just an ordinary guy who happens to be privileged to be useful to you.
Your girlfriend should be lucky.
Yeah, she should be.
So are you heading towards the studio?
Yeah, I am, actually.
Because I'm kind of heading towards our side too. Would you like to walk with me?
I'd love to.
What's the definition of life? Without a purpose, without a cause, meaningless and vain. Riches and fame, striving in lust, to the pleasure of dead, beauty is vain. Status and power, lust and time, pursuit of flesh, all begun. The deeper you dive in, you lose yourself. Destruction and darkness, condemnation and pain. Oh, come on home. Peace dwells here, abundance here. Everything made known in Jesus, grace and mercy for all. Choose life today, yeah. Mercy is here today. Oh, come on home. Peace dwells here, abundance here. Everything made known in Jesus, grace and mercy
for all.
Mike. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Mom. Good afternoon, Dad.
Good afternoon. How are you, son? Isabella, right? Mm.
Yes, Ma.
Wow, come and give me a hug. You are such a beauty.
Good job, Ma.
Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you too, Ma.
You know, my son has never brought home a lady before. You are the first. And I hope.
Mom!
I'm serious.
Well, Mike is a really awesome guy, and I cannot see a future without him.
Wow, fantastic. My Mike is now a big man, picking on a lady.
Yeah, Mike is a wonderful young man.
Excuse me, Mom, but I need to go use the restroom.
Okay, let's take our guest in. You're welcome.
Isabella,
Ma,
please get the door.
Oh,
hello.
This is my friend Mike. Mike, this is my mom.
Baby, hello, Michael. The Kovacs. Oh, good to see you.
Very glad to see you too.
So how are your parents?
They're very fine, Mom.
Alright, why are you standing there like a prom queen? Get him something to drink.
We don't worry, he doesn't need anything to drink.
Hey, Isabella, be careful.
Yes, Mom.
Wait, Isabel. What are you doing? We can't possibly do this.
Why? You don't love me or what?
I don't.
You don't?
No, I mean I do.
But why don't you want to make commitment to me? I'm not good enough for you.
Come on, Isabel. You're more than good enough for me. But this is too soon. We need more time to get to know each other better.
I feel like I've known you all my life.
But we haven't. Besides, why are we rushing?
I don't get you, Mike. You say you love me, but you don't want to touch me.
I'm scared.
Scared of what?
I'm afraid of spoiling what we have.
How? If anything, this brings people together. I want us to be together.
Are you sure about this?
Yes.
How can I live?
How can I move?
How is it not okay to
it's
you?
It's too expensive. Yeah.
How can I be without you?
Isabel, we've sinned.
Sinned against who?
God, of course.
Why?
Stop fooling around, Isabel. This is serious.
Okay. So just because of one night of fun, and suddenly the whole of heaven is angry with us.
What?
Like, am I going to hell?
What I've been feeling since that day, it's more than hell.
So am I supposed to go to hell with you?
Isabel!
Don't be daft, Mike. These things happen all the time. Besides, what's your stress?
Look, don't get me wrong. What I'm saying
is... Save your breath. Look, if you don't have anything better to say to me, I suggest we call it a day. Just as I suspected. Okay, so if you don't mind, I have rehearsals to go prepare for.
Without you, how can
I don't know how I could have been so stupid to have fallen into her laps. I should never have gone for this politics of a thing. Ever since I got in, it's been from one temptation to another. And you want me. Mr. Festus, you warned me, you warned me, you warned me. Oh, look how stupid I am. Look how stupid I am. Oh, God. I don't deserve him. I don't deserve him.
He's well, Mike.
I don't deserve him.
He's well. Please look up. I need you to look at me. Yes, look up. I understand how you feel. But please, at this point, self-condemnation is not the way out of this situation. At least you're doing something for the Lord. Are you not?
I know.
Look at two characters in the Bible. Judas and Peter. Judas sold Christ. Peter denied him when he most needed him. Judas, at the end of the day, committed suicide. But Peter, on the other hand, rose to become a great apostle. Who, out of the two, do you want to be like?
Peter.
As long as we are in this race, you will always be a target of the enemy. You may fall sometimes. The righteous may fall 7 times, but the good thing is, we will always rise. As a person, I don't condone sin. I'm not going to allow this self-pity to consume you. Therefore, you need to pick up the pattern and run the race that is set before you.
Absolutely, Mike. You may have fallen to the ground, but that doesn't mean you cannot get up and run again. So get up and run. Okay?
Thank you.
Mike, I need you to rise. Get up.
am so grateful to the organizers of this event, and I would just like to say a very big thank you to everyone who nominated and voted for me as the next beauty queen of campus. But even though I won, I believe that everyone here is a winner. And I would also like to say that as the next beauty queen of campus, I am not only a queen, I am also a representative, and I promise to represent everyone on campus, male or female, properly and equally, and promise to make sure that your voices are heard all over this campus, all over the school, and all over the world. Thank you guys so much. I love you.
Hello, Dogun. I've not seen the money till now. If you don't put that money in my account before 12 p.m. tomorrow, you will experience the fullness of my route, okay?
Chief, that... now. Chief, where have you been? I've been looking for you everywhere.
Isabella, where are you going?
Chief, to class. I'm still a student.
You don't need all that now, Isabella. You know you have me now, eh?
Chief, please, I don't want to hear all that one.
Isabella.
Chief, please, I need money to settle some things in school. You know I've missed 5 tests because of you.
I know, Isabella. I know. Too much money. I will double those money for you, okay? Huh? Sorry, that's my wife. Hello, honey. Yes, we're in a board meeting. I won't be home tonight. Yeah, tomorrow morning, okay? Take care, love you. So, where was I before that rude interruption?
Chief, that's your wife.
Yes, I know, but you are my baby. Okay, come to daddy, come to daddy, come to daddy.
Chief, please don't. Hello? Yes? Sorry, can you speak up? What? Where? When? How? Where? Where?
Oh my god.
I'm on my way. Chief, sorry, I need
Isabella,
to
where are you going?
Chief, I'm coming.
Isabel, a lot has changed about you.
Yeah, I guess so.
But you haven't changed since last time we... I'm really sorry about what happened between us.
No need to be sorry. I chose my path, you chose yours, and we both took responsibilities. It's fine.
Look, Isabel, is it possible?
Possible for what?
For you to come back.
Come back to where? Look, I don't even know my way back.
There is a way, Isabel. There is.
And what way is that?
Jesus is the way. You can find your peace, your joy, and your hope through him.
And does Jesus know how far I've lost my way?
It's exactly your type of people he came to die for, Isabel. For your sake, he paid the price for forgiveness. So your sins in the past, in the present, and in the future will be forgiven. All you have to do is surrender yourself to him, and he'll accept you the way you are.
Just like that?
Well, yeah, just like that.
Okay, so if I do come back to Jesus, will he take care of me? Will he pay my bill?
Look, all you have to do is just cast all your cares on him, because he cares for you. He formed you in your mother's womb. Pretty sure he can take care of you better than any man could. What happened?
I came all this way to talk to you, Mike, and all you can talk about is how I don't need a man in my life.
Look, Isabel, you're missing the point here.
Then what is the point? You look at me with your church eyes and you judge me.
I'm not judging you.
Then what is all this talk about me not needing a man in my life, as if all my life has been about men?
That's not even the point.
You know what? I thought by now you would have grown up. I gave myself to you and you couldn't even appreciate it one bit. Let me ask you, where was Jesus when you were tasting the honey from my honey pot? Was he tasting it with you too?
Jesus, Isabel!
You said he lives in you, but he didn't leave you when you pulled your stunt on me.
Look, we made mistakes a long time ago. It doesn't mean we should let our past decide who we are.
It's so easy for you to say it like that. But it took so long for me to repress the cravings I had for you after my encounter with you. But you weren't there to satisfy me.
Well, what we did was wrong.
And you leaving me was right.
Look, I didn't leave you. We just drifted apart.
And did you do anything to try to keep me, to try to get me back? You have no excuse, Mike. None at all.
Look, Isabel, there's some things in my past I wish I could bury.
That's your business, not mine.
Guest, Mike.
Mike. Rotty.
Yes, this is my son, Mike.
Mike, how are you? I've heard a lot about you.
Really?
Yes, I have. Mike, this is Rotty Ayeni. She's the daughter of my friend, Mrs. Ayeni. She just graduated from Cambridge University in United Kingdom. First class honor. And she'll soon be going back for her master's. She just stay on short vacation. I want you to meet her. And then you guys should talk. Well, excuse you. Talk, talk. Mike.
So Mike, how are you?
I'm good, you know. Yeah. Tell me about yourself.
Well, studied.
Hello, Chief. They are here.
To where Chief paid for.
Chief is in his house entertaining one of his guests,
so this way is free for
we
us.
Have the place to ourselves.
John!
Leave him alone! Leave him alone!
John, leave him alone! Leave him alone!
Chief, I'm sorry, Chief. Please, Chief, I'm sorry. Chief, please, I'm sorry.
What? Chief Ernest, you told me these girls are coming.
Roland, be patient, be patient.
I just don't have all day.
I know you're a busy man. Don't worry. Let me roll them in for you.
Jay!
She's beautiful.
But I don't want her. Roland, you don't want this one?
You have high taste.
Pamela! Pamela! Roland? Rita!
She's very beautiful. but.
What?
I don't want her.
Ah, Roland.
I know you have more girls.
Okay, no problem then.
Sonia!
Is very special.
Ah!
Let me just show it to you.
Ah! I trust you.
Seriously thinking of coming back home to see you.
Oh, me too. I can't wait to see you too.
I'll be back in a couple of days.
Awesome! I can't wait to see you.
Just make sure you have a safe trip back, okay?
Thank you, darling. I love you.
Love you too.
Isabella,
I've heard so much about you. So bad things got bad between you and Chief. But I think you will be more useful to me here in Abuja.
So you kidnapped me, or rather you sent your boys to kidnap me and brought me all the way to Abuja, all against my will.
I'm so sorry for the unusual means of transportation, but it was urgent. Moreover, you are very familiar with all my customers. They enjoyed your service the last time. So, they particularly requested for you to deliver this product. All right, here's the deal. I will give you the product. Of course, you know my business. And I'll give you a down payment of 500,000 naira.
And what if I refuse?
You won't like to make Papa upset, would you? Would you?
Cheers. Cheers.
James, yes?
Where are you now? You said you were going to come and pick me. You see where I wanted to take my car. You're late.
You're almost here. We have to be fast.
No, don't stop at any eatery. Just come here straight.
Thank you.
Isabella!
Thank you.
Honey, have you gotten through to him?
No, it's ringing, but no one is picking it.
It's unusual. Is he in a meeting or what?
It's last night. What sort of meeting is that?
Is he the one calling?
Yes. Hello? Hello? Michael?
Hello, sir. Is this Mr. Digital Kova, Michael's father?
Yes. Who am I speaking with?
I am Dr. Smith, the medical director of Lifeline Hospital, Abuja.
What? I mean, yes, yes. Lifeline director.
Your son is presently in our intensive care unit.
Intensive what?
Eh?
How? When?
So much to tell you, sir, but I will advise you come over to Abuja so you can see your son.
Okay.
Who?
Okay, thank you.
Who?
Thank you. My son.
Your son? Who's
yes.
Your son?
Michael.
Michael who?
Michael Dakoba.
Yes. A minute, please. And you are?
Deji Dakoba is my name.
Hello, good morning, Dr. Smith. Mr. Deji Dakoba is here to see you. Okay. Okay, thank you, sir. He'll be with you shortly.
No problem, thank you.
Please, could you have your seat,
no,
sir?
No, I'll be fine, thank you. Thank you. I'll be fine, yeah. Yes, please. How is my son doing?
Oh, your son was in the coma.
Ah.
And what is recuperating? His vital signs are improving steadily.
Doctor,
we
please.
We hope he will be out of coma soon.
Can I see him, please?
Oh, of course. Let's go.
He sustained a serious trauma to his head.
Ah.
And we have to perform an operation to stitch the laceration on his head together. But I think he should be out of coma in a short while.
Doctor, his brain. What about his brain? Hope he's not affected.
Oh, fortunately not.
Ah.
The coma was caused in the first instance by a severe impact upon his head called concussion. But the injury is not so deep. And I do not envisage any complication if he doesn't stay too long in this coma state.
Doctor, how did he sustain this kind of injury in the first instance?
Mr. Idris, the security officer of the hotel, will let you into all this.
The chief security officer?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Excuse me, please.
Huh. You mean he was attacked?
Yes. Your son was attacked while he was trying to rescue an innocent lady.
Really?
Mr. Dakoba, I must commend the efforts of your son. From the record that we have, the lady was actually being attacked by some rogues.
Really?
Yes. If not for the timely intervention of your son, do you know that the girl will have been dead by now.
Where is this girl now? Where is this lady now?
She escaped. And that is the beautiful part of it. The only thing that we know that her name is Stephanie.
So you mean my son almost lost his life for a lady that does not know? So where is this lady now?
Unfortunately, we don't know. If she had not escaped, she would have been dead. But the truth of the matter is the police are on top of their game. And they will definitely get to the root of this matter.
Ah,
Dad, zo, diakuri, kwanta da hankalinki, kin ji ko? Nan gida ta ce, kin ji, kina can agoje na kama ki, na ganki kina kwanciya a kasa. Shi yasa na kawo ki gidata. Kin ji ko? Eh, it's you are side there, I bring you. Eh, peace, don't worry, peace. Come, sleep again. You want water? You want water? Drink your food. You don't drink. You want food? You're okay? No. Don't worry, eh? Don't worry. I'll take care of you. Injipo, pack your damu. Ninki da tachi.
Something strange is happening at the hospital right now.
Really?
Yes. We have observed the movement of a strange man who has strayed into Michael's room twice now. And each time they were accosted by the nurses, they claimed they missed their way.
What does this mean now?
It's obvious that Michael knows some things they don't want him to know, and they're after his life.
So, what do you think we should do?
We have made an arrangement. Michael has to be moved very fast, and we have made an arrangement with our hairline that has a space for three, and the plane must leave for Lagos in the next 2 hours. It is very important that you go along with them.
Thank you very much for your help.
You are welcome.
God sir. Bless you.
Thank you so much, sir.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
I wish I knew. All I know was that I sent Michael on an official trip. He ended up protecting the lady that he never knew from Ada. He ended up protecting the lady with his life, risking his own life doing so.
So what do we do now?
Nothing. Nothing but to watch and pray.
Thank you.
Mr. and Mrs. Dakuba, please come in. Please come. As you can see, he's awake.
Oh, my boy!
Oh. Mike, sweetie, how are you? Are you okay? Doctor, why is he not saying anything?
Oh, he just woke from coma, so he can't really engage you in any discussion right now. You still need to give him some time to rest.
Where is she?
My God! He speaks!
Yes, he speaks.
How are you, my love?
Where am I?
You are in the hospital. Mike, don't you remember anything?
You are in Abuja, Mike.
Where is she?
She?
Yes.
She's there.
Mike, how are you?
Where is she?
She? Who is the she?
Isabella.
Isabella?
Isabella.
Monty, what is wrong with you? Since we came out of Mike's room, you've not said anything to me. Why are you moody? Monty, say something.
Mike wakes up from coma and all he remembers his ex-girlfriend.
What you have to understand, he's just coming out of coma.
And that does not stop him from remembering that former slut in his life.
Excuse me, Ronti, that's my son you're talking about here.
I can't believe this is happening to me. I can't believe it.
Take it easy, Ronti. Eh? Don't get yourself unnecessarily worked on or nothing. It's just a trivia issue. Just calm down. Just give him time. You know he's not his usual self. Just give him time, please.
But I'm afraid that's exactly what bothers me.
What do you mean?
How come Mike wakes up and he doesn't remember me? That's what bothers me. What if he never remembers me?
Bronte, stop being pessimistic. Eh? I assure you, this memory of yours is going to come back to him. Just give him time.
How come I'm not convinced?
I beg your pardon, Ronti. Eh? Instead of being pessimistic, I'm being sentimental. All you could do, we have prayed and we have believed. And I want you to just join your faith with us so that we can hope for the best. And I'm sure he's going to come out of this state. Please give him time.
Okay. I'll work on my faith.
That's better.
Quickly, nurse, relax. Mr. Mike, look at me.
Where is she?
Can you see me? Just relax, eh? Please, just relax. So, Mr. and Mrs. Jacob, please, I'd like to know, who is this girl in question that your son has been talking about? Who is she?
Doctor, her name is Isabella, Mike's ex-fiancée. sure that they met somewhere in Abuja. No reason why Mike is assaulted.
Oh, I see. But let me be honest with the two of you. I have seen this emotion of love do things to a man that medicine cannot.
So what do we do now, Doctor?
Well, I don't know what has transpired exactly between your son and this girl in question. But I believe that your son has a deep emotion, a deep affection for this girl.
But Doctor, what is the medical implication of this deep affection and emotion?
Well, more of a psychological implication. And it has been proven medically and statistically that a patient in coma will respond positively to the voice of their loved ones. Yes.
You're talking of Isabella here?
Yeah? Exactly. And it won't hurt us if we attempt to actually try the psychological dimension. So, while we work on resuscitating him out of the tranquilized state, we can as well look for this girl called Isabella and bring her to talk to him. Peradventure, his condition might improve better.
Mrs. Dakoba, you're welcome.
Thank you.
I'm so sorry about your son. I hope he's getting better. And please, whatsoever it is I can do, I'll be glad to do that.
That's why I'm here, Mrs. Dakoba.
Okay?
To see your daughter Isabella.
Why?
My son, Mike, is losing his mind. And we believe your daughter is the only one that can help him. Please call her out.
I can't understand it. But as I speak, yes. I have not set my eyes on Isabella for weeks now.
Where is she?
I don't know.
Hello, honey. Hello. Yeah. There's been a terrible accident. Yes, on the highway.
Yes, honey. Yes. Yeah, she's the only survivor. I brought her to the hospital. Yes, yes, yes. She's in a terrible state. We need to raise prayers for her. Right away. Right away, yes. We need to raise prayers for her. There's a serious warfare on her life. Yes. I have this strong nudging. Yes, please, please, please. Thank you. We're at the hospital. When our backs were against the
wall, and it looked as if it was over. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Sweetheart, let's begin to pray and commit that gentle lady into the hands of the Lord in the hospital, that the hand of God will visit her. Let's thank God for sparing her life. At least she's currently in the hospital. She did not die. Let's commit her soul into the hands of the Lord, Amen. That she will revive.
Amen.
That everything that needs to be done will be done according to the will of the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord will give wisdom to the doctors.
Amen.
That the enemy will not take her life,
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Come against the powers of hell, against the powers of darkness, that desire to do this, in the name of Jesus. Father, we declare, it shall not be, she shall live.
Jesus, please. Have mercy upon Isabella.
Hey, Nico, your father, Lord.
Release Isabella from wherever she's held in bondage. Lord, have mercy upon my daughter. Lord, I pray for Isabella. Let your power, oh God, reach out to her and release her from every bondage. Every power, oh God, that is holding her captive. Lord, I pray for Isabella. Restore her, oh God.
And lose your hold upon that land. Lose your hold upon that land. In the name of Jesus, I pray. I counsel, oh God, let your will be done. Father, let your balm of Gilead come upon her. Let there be healing, total healing. Let there be deliverance in the name of Jesus. She will arise from that sickbed. Honey, call upon the name of the Lord that she will not die. Her destiny will be fulfilled in the name of Jesus. She will live.
Let mercy prevail.
Amen.
In the name Amen. Of Jesus. Amen. Mercy over her Amen. Life. Amen. Over the Amen. Life of Isabella. Amen. Let Isabella. Your blood in the name of Jesus. Lord, have mercy upon my
Lord,
daughter.
Yes,
she will fulfill God's purpose. Father, we thank you. Lord, we pray. Let your hand rest upon her. You're the balm of Gilead. From the crown of her head to the sole of her feet. Let there be flow of your power. Let there be flow of your will. In the name of Jesus.
Isabel. Isabel, wake up. My love, wake up.
I want to wake up. I'm tired.
You have to. We need you here now.
Why do you love me? Why?
Because love never fails.
But I don't deserve your love.
Isabel, before he formed you in the womb, he knew you. He chose you to love you. And nothing, I repeat, nothing can turn my heart away from you.
Thank you. Thank you for loving me this much. Is this our daughter?
Yes, my dear.
She's so beautiful.
Too much, please. Relax yourself.
Where's Mike?
Mike? It's all good. Just be calm. Just be calm.
Where am I?
Your brother had an accident. I'll get the doctor. Just relax. Please relax.
When our backs were against the wall, and it looked as if it was over, you made we
I know I strayed far away. I know, Lord, I know, I know. But here I am, at this point in my life, and I'm begging for you to take me back. I'm begging you, God, to take me back, to cleanse me, oh Lord, and make me worthy to be before you. Oh Lord, I want to turn in my rags for a new garment. Lord, please take me back into your arms, into your love, into your kindness. Take me back as your child, as your daughter. Oh Lord, I am here and I am begging for your
should have flesh all begun.